This is the question asked in today's SkillRack daily challenge. So we are given n integers as input and we also have to print n integers as our output. So let us see how we are printing these integers as our output. Suppose when we are printing the first integer, if the first integer in the given input array is even, then we have to add the integer with all the remaining integers even digits. So the first integer 32 is even, so we have to take all the remaining integers. So except 32, the remaining integers are 25, 16 and 71. Now we have to add all the even digits present in these integers. So the even digit in 25 is 2, and even digit in 16 is 6, and there is no even digit in 71. So we should add this 6 and 2. So 6 plus 2 is 8. And we should add this 8 with this integer completely. So 32 plus 8 is equal to 40. So the first integer of our output is 40. Similarly, if the integer is odd, we should do the reverse. So here 25 is an odd integer. So we should take all the integers except 25. So the remaining integers are 32, 16 and 17. 32 is even, so we added all the even digits, but 25 is odd. So in this case, we should add all the odd digits in the remaining integers. So in 32, the odd digit is 3, and in 16, the odd digit is 1, and in 71, 7, 1, both are odd integers. Now we should add all these. So 7 plus 1 is 8, and then here 1, so 8 plus 1 is 9, and 9 plus 3 is 12. Now we should add this 12 with 25. So 25 plus 12 is equal to 37. So we print 37 as our second integer. So like this, we should print the remaining integers. To solve this problem, what we will be doing is, first we will create two integer variables named sum of all odd and sum of all even. So in these integer variables, we will be storing the sum of all integers even digits in this integer variable and sum of all odd digits in this integer variable. So while accepting our input itself, we will calculate the sum of odd digits and even digits separately and store them into this variable. So while accepting 32, the digit 3 is odd and the digit 2 is even. So after accepting 32, the integer variable sum of all odd will be 3 and the sum of all even will be 2. And after 32, when we accept 25, the odd in it is 5 and the even in it is 2. So we will add the 5 in this variable and we will add the 2 in the sum of all even variable. So the next integer is 16. So 1 is odd and 6 is even. So 6 will be added here and 1 will be added above. And then in the last variable, both the digits are odd. So 7, 1, both will be added here. Now when we add all these, the values will be 17. And for even, the value would be 10. So the sum of all odd digits in every integers is 17 and the sum of all even digits in every integers is 10. So now we want to print our output. So print our output, again we would be traversing through this array. And suppose if you are at the first integer is 32. So 32 is an even integer. So what we will be doing is, we will add 32 first. And then we will add the sum of all even digits, because 32 is an even integer. So we will add the sum of all even to this integer. So it will become 32 plus 10. And we will subtract the even integers from this 32. So the sum of even in this 32 is 2. So we will get 32 plus 10 is 42 and minus 2 is equal to 40. So our expected output is also 40. So like this, we will be printing our output. Now let us see how to write a C program for this. So first I am creating two functions named oddSum and evenSum. And this function accepts the integer n in the arguments and returns the sum of all the odd digits present in the integer n. So to do that, I am going to create a new integer variable named sum and I am assigning the value 0 to it initially. And then we have to traverse through every digits in the integer n. So I'm creating a while loop that iterates until the value of n becomes equal to 0. And in every iteration, we will be comparing the integer n mod 10. So if the digit n mod 10 is even, then we will add it with the integer variable sum. So if n mod 10 mod 2 is not equal to 0, then we will be adding that n mod 10 with the integer sum. And in every iteration, we will be dividing n by 10. And once when the value of n becomes equal to 0, we will return the value of sum. So that sum will be the sum of all the odd digits in the integer n. The same we are going to perform in this function. So instead of odd, we will be checking the sum of even digits. So in the if condition alone, instead of n mod 10 mod 2 is not equal to 0, we will replace it with equal to 0. So all the even digits will be added and the function will return the sum of even digits in it. So now let us go to our main function. So in our main function, first I am creating a new integer n, and in the next line I am accepting the integer n, and then I am creating an array named arr of size n, and then I am creating two integer variables named sum of all odd digits and sum of all even digits, and I am setting their values initially to 0. And then I am going to create a for loop that iterates from 0 to n, and we will be accepting the n integers as input and store it into the array arr. And soon after accepting the input, we are going to calculate the sum of odd digits and the sum of even digits in it and add it in this integer variable sum of all odd digits and sum of all even digits. So soon after accepting our input, we have the sum of all odd digits in every integers in the variable sum of all odd digits and the sum of all even digits in every integers in the variable sum of all even digits. So now we have to print our output. To do that, we are going to again iterate through the array arr. So I am creating a for loop that iterates from 0 to n, and in every iteration, if the integer arr of I mod 2 is equal to 0, that is, if the integer is even, then I am going to print the integer by adding the integer with sum of all even digits and subtract the even sum in the integer arr of I. Suppose if the integer in the array is odd, then we are going to print the integer added with sum of all odd digits minus the sum of odd in arr of I. So we will get our desired output. Now let us check our program with sample test cases. Given the sample input 1 and our expected output is here. So we also get the same integers as our output. And now I have given the sample input 2 and our expected output is here. So we also get the same integers. So this is the logic behind today's daily challenge. Thank you for watching.